Shakespeare's. Okay, so Shakespeare's head is there. And why does the poet say that Shakespeare is wicked? Surely Shakespeare is wicked. What is it that Shakespeare has done wrong that he is called wicked? Such a great literary person. So much of, what you can say, literature and language he has taught us. What is it that makes him wicked? Because what he has written about, Mohit Sid Strait, what he has written about, it seems everything is a lie, right? And when these students are going to read about it, they'll be tempted to steal, to escape from this life. So he's giving them false hope. He's giving them a false impression. Now look at this line, the first line of the second stanza. Surely Shakespeare is wicked. Surely Shakespeare. What is the device over here? What do we call a repetition of a consonant sound? What do we call a repetition of a consonant sound? What is it called? Yes, Manreet? Alliteration. Very good. So surely Shakespeare. Please note down in your books, what is the device over here? It is alliteration. There is one more thing. Shakespeare. Allusion. When one person is there, it is not only about Shakespeare, but there are so many writers and dramatists and poets like Shakespeare. So allusion is when we have one name referring to more people of that kind. So Shakespeare is representative of one literary person. We have so many writers, we have so many poets. So here, this is what? Allusion. Okay, please write down. I have A-L-L-U-S-I-O-N. Are you writing at home? Are you writing there? Give me yes or no. Please remember this device. Please remember. Now, from the second stanza, can you pick a simile? Can any one of you pick a simile from there? Yes, Varun? Tell me the simile in the second stanza. Look at the book. Yeah, do you have the book or not? You are Varun. I don't think so. He has joined. Right? So what is the simile over here? Look at the paragraph. Look at the stanza. Identify. Very good. Very good. Varun, underline it. Like bottle bits on stones. When do we like, of course, how is it a simile? How is it a simile? Because it's a comparison. Simile is used for a comparison. Metaphor is used for a comparison. So simile here, how are we able to identify it? The words use and like. They tell us that this is a simile. Okay. And here, what is the comparison like bottle bits on stone? It is about the slum children, their appearance, how they look so unhealthy, how they look very malnourished. Bottle bits. What's the device over here? Once again, it is alliteration. Now, can you come back to the first stanza? Can you look at the first stanza, please? Yes. Okay. Can you identify a metaphor in the first stanza? Paper seeming. Very right. Okay. Paper seeming boy. He is not thin as paper. He is paper. We have assumed him to be. So when we talk about a simile, it is a comparison. When we talk about a metaphor, it is that quality. Okay. Right? So we have been able to. What is far, far? First line, two words. Far, far from gusty waves. Far, far, yes, it is alliteration. It is repetition also. When the same word is repeated, we call it repetition. Look at the second line, first word, first three words. Like rootless weeds. Identify. Simile. Right? Who are the rootless weeds? The children are the rootless weeds. Okay? Right? Yes. Now, right, when we look at the first stanza, do I see any rhyme scheme? Faces, pallor, paper, air, disease, class, dream, this. Try. Faces and faces rhymes with any word? We put an A. Pallor, paper, same. There's some rhyme. Air, disease, class, dream, this. So it's not a regular rhyme scheme, but there are rhyming words, okay? So we can give a different letter and we give the same letter to the rhyming word. Like pallor, paper, disease, this. Right? Yes. Okay. So we have been able to identify. Now look at the second stanza once again. What is Belled Flowery Tyrolese Valley? What is that? What does this mean? Belled Flowery Tyrolese Valley. Yes, students at home, I am not getting any response from you. What is your problem? Can I see your answers? Can I see your answers? Are you listening? Belled Flowery Tyrolese Valley. So it's a picture of a beautiful valley. Now, if I look at it, now when I talk about alliteration here, alliteration is repetition of a consonant sound. When there is a repetition of a vowel sound, that is called as, please note down, assonance. E, E, O. What are the vowels? A, E, I, O, U. Right? So where there is the repetition of vowel sound, what do we call it? Assonance. Please write down. Here in this line, Belled, Flowery, Tyrolese, Valley, open-handed map. Repetition of vowels. So many vowels have been used. Okay? Right. Now let's come to this one. We had done the third stanza also. Why Shakespeare is wicked? Why the map should not be there? What should we put on the window? Or what should the children see? They should be not looking at the map, but the window there or the outside view. What we should blot it. Because what is visible from the window of the school? The slum. So where is the life confined to? In the slum. Do they have any hopes or dreams of getting out of it? No. That is why they think that Shakespeare is wicked. Shakespeare is giving them false dreams. Shakespeare is giving them false hope. That, yes, that they can come out of this world, they can come out of the slums, and they are having these false hopes and they're having these false aspirations. Okay? Right. So that is why Shakespeare is wicked and the map a bad example. Fine. Third stanza is clear. Any doubt? Sure? Okay. Let's come to the last stanza. Unless governor inspector visitor. This map becomes their window and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Break, oh break open till they break the town and show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands and let their tongues run naked into books. The white and green leaves open. History theirs whose language is the sun. Can anyone tell me what this stanza means? I'm telling you, coming to that. Yes? Their future. How can their future change? Now, till now, all these three stanzas that we have discussed yesterday, they are talking about inequality. They're talking about lack of opportunities. They are talking about how the lives of these children will remain in the slums. They can't come out of them. Right? Here in this stanza, we are coming across optimism. What does optimism mean? Positivity. There is hope. How can that hope be? How can we bring that change? Unless governor, inspector, visitor. Who do you think are the governor, inspector, and the visitor? Who are they? The people coming, seeing these schools. The people who are responsible for growth, development, change. So they should not just come and see the school. Oh, the school is in such a bad condition. So many things need to be done. They should make things happen. They should do things, right? This map becomes their window. Where is the map? Where's the map? On the wall. What is the map showing the children? The world. But what is their world? The window. And what does the window show them? The slums. So what is their world? The slums. What should happen? Let us change things. What should become their world? The map should become their world. The map should be visible. Or when they look outside the window, what do they see? They see this world full of opportunities. Okay? Am I clear? Right? This map becomes their windows. And these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Catacombs are burial places, right? Graves. Okay? That is what catacombs are, right? So these are like, of course, it seems these windows have closed upon them. They are like graves for them because of the lack of opportunities. Their life, death, future, everything over here. They can't go out of that window of opportunity. Okay? So what does catacomb mean? Tombs. What are tombs? The graves for the dead, right? So how can we change that? How can they come out of these catacombs? How can they come out of these tombs when we open these windows, right? So when we give them opportunities, yes, that shut upon their lives like catacombs. We have read in the previous stanza what the lives of these slum children is like. How they are going to be confined in the slums, how they look so unhealthy, how they look so malnourished, and how there is no hope for a better future for them, right? So their future is dull. The window that they see, the sky that they see is so dull. So when that window is open, we can open for them opportunities. Who can bring about the change? The governor, inspector, visitor, okay? Right. Break open till they break the town. Repetition, break. Break open. What should they break? The windows. Yes. They should break the windows, the barriers. Where should they go? Into the town. Otherwise, these people, they are confined here. In a way, what does it mean? Bring them out and let them be a part of the mainstream. Right? Break open the town. Town. Let them be in the town. Let them reach the town. Because where have they been throughout their lives? Where have they been throughout their lives? In the slum. Let them come out. And show the children to green fields. We're talking color over here. Otherwise, the gray sky, fog, dark night. These are the things that we have been talking about. Show them green fields. Show them the beauty of nature. What does green fields mean over here? The beauty of nature. Make their world run azure on gold sands. Gold sands. Where do you find the gold sands? Yes? The beach. So show them the beauty of nature. Show them the beautiful fields. Show them the golden sand. Show them the blue sky, azure. Right? Let them run free on the sand. Let them run under the blue sky. And we're talking about color here. Let us bring a change in their lives. And let their tongues run naked into books, the white and green leaves open. Give them opportunities. Once you open this window, once you break these windows and say, come out of them, reach the town, go and see the beauty of nature. See the beautiful world around you, right? What will happen? Give them opportunities, run naked into books. The white, white here is the printed books. Look at your page, white and black, isn't it? Give them the opportunity to learn. And green leaves open. Learn from books as well as from nature. Green leaves, nature. So let them learn from the books as well as from nature. And then, yes, history theirs whose language is the sun. So history is witness that people who got opportunities to grow, right, where there were no boundaries or limits for them, they are the ones who have changed. They are the ones who have made use of these opportunities. Okay, so the sun, once again, showing that positivity, brightness, that once you give them opportunities, you take them out of the slum, show them the beautiful world around them, only then they will hope to change. Clear? Is the last answer clear to all of you? Can I get a yes or no, please?
Yes.
Okay. Now, what is the tone in the last stanza? What is the tone in the last stanza? The poet, is he optimistic or is he pessimistic? He's optimistic. Optimism means positive. Pessimistic means negative, right? So here, yes, he is optimistic. And how can that happen? How can the change happen? Who can bring about the change? People can bring about the change. Which people can bring about the change? Governor, inspector, visitor. Don't come and just see these, have pity on these people and wonder how they live their lives over there. Make that change. And of course, what has the classroom been compared to? Catacomb, where their lives or the slum has been compared to the catacomb, that is the graves. Right? Where, of course, here, naturally, it seems as if they are not aware of what is happening in the outside world. So make them come out of that. Break the windows. Break the barriers. Take them out. Give them a chance to learn from nature. Give them a chance to learn from books. Right? And then see how they will grow and see how they will prosper. So history is witness. So when we have given opportunities, people have changed, people have grown. Do you think here we are also talking about the education system? How can the education system be changed to bring opportunities to everyone? How can it be changed? How can it be changed? Yes? Free education. They're getting free education. There's no change in their lives. What else? What else? Yes? Giving them opportunities. Take them out. Show them where the opportunities are. Make them able to deal with the challenges. Make them able to deal with the possibilities that are there. And do you think it is only for these people or it should be for everyone? We should be given such kind of learning that makes us capable to deal with the challenges of life, right? So we should have certain skills, how to deal with the changes, how to deal with what is expected from us. And yes, of course, if I have to find a work or if I have to do something, I should be equipped to be able to deal with the challenges. Okay, right. Can you tell me the name of the poet, please? Who's the poet? Stephen Spender. Okay. Now, when I look at the last stanza, what is the device over here? What is break or break? Till the break of the town. Break, break, break. Repetition. Okay. Yes. Green leaves. Metaphor. Right? Of course, here, right? These leaves, which leaves are there? The leaves of nature. Books, the white and green leaves of the text here, right? Now let's look at these questions here. Tick the item which best answers the following. Let's see how much you remember. Yes. The tall girl with the way down head means the girl is ill and exhausted. Has her head bent with shame or has untidy hair? First or second? Second is absolutely correct. The tall girl with the way down head. Why is her head way down? As I told you, because of her poverty, because of the problems in her life, because of the suffering in her life. Yes. The paper seeming boy with rat's eyes means, wear your mask, please. The boy is thin, hungry, and weak. Yes, constantly looking for food. The stunted, unlucky heir of twisted bones means. Yes, he has an inherited disability. Yes, because his bones are not properly developed and he's showing his problem to the world. Right. The children's faces are compared to rootless weeds. This means they are insecure, ill-fed, or wasters. Huh? Fourth miss kar diya. Okay, fourth. His eyes live in a dream, a squirrel's game in the tree room. Other this mean the boy is? Is it? If I say third? Third. The boy is distracted. He's supposed to be in the class. He's supposed to be listening. But what is he dreaming of? He's thinking of future. Or rather, he wants to be outside the school. He's not interested in studies at all. He wants to go out. He's distracted. Yeah, have a man full of hope for the future? No. Next one, rootless weeds. The faces are, they are insecure. They are insecure, I would say. Because, right, why are they here? They're not even sure what there is. Okay? But of course, when in the next line, of course, when you talk about the pallor, the paleness of the face, like rudeness means unkempt hair also, right? So it is about their appearance also. What do you think is the color of sour cream? Pale. Why do you think the poet has used this expression to describe the classroom walls? It's because the white paint has turned to yellow because of neglect, because no one has paid any attention to the school for a long time, right? The walls of the classroom are decorated with the pictures of Shakespeare, buildings with domes, world maps, and beautiful valleys. How do these contrast with the world of these children? How do they contrast? It's a big contrast. Is their world in any way linked with Shakespeare? Is their world any way linked with the beautiful valley which is shown? No. So it is there, right? So nowadays also, do you think here, right, when we do talk about so many things, we talk about change and growth and development, do you think that change can only happen when we think about the person with the least facilities and the least opportunities? It should be keeping those people in mind, or it should be keeping the ones who already are there having a lot of facilities and a lot of opportunities. So these children are like that. They don't know what is there around them. So they are not aware of the importance of those things. What does the poet want for the children of the slums? Okay, we've come to the end of the